Hello everybody, glad you could make it. My name is Kaylee Ellen and welcome to 5 Plants I Regret Selling. Now, this might be a little bit different for me compared to a lot of other people, maybe you guys at home, because I have to get used to selling plants that I love every day, right? It's pretty normal for me that something will come into the shop, for example, and I'll just fall in love with it and I won't want to sell it. And sometimes I might even hold on to it for a couple of months to delay selling it. On the whole, I would say that I'm pretty tolerant of selling plants. I don't often regret things. And I think really I'm pretty comfortable in selling plants, definitely more now than what I was way back then. It was a lot different for me back then. I really struggled back then when I opened the shop. And I guess that really shows because I have my list here of plants that I want to talk to you about today. And honestly, they're a while ago. Nearly every single plant, in fact, every single plant on this list is not something I didn't even purchase them last year. So we're talking quite old. I think this is like a year to 2 years ago, these plants. And I think that is a hallmark of, you know, I'm just okay with plants being sold now, and I don't form an attachment to plants as easy. And while a lot of people might think that that's quite sad, I don't think it is. I think doing what I do, I kind of need to have that. But without further ado, I'm going to take you through purchases I've made in the past. It could be for the shop, it could just be for me, that I really regret getting rid of. And in some cases, replacing the plant still isn't really going to cut it. I'm always going to feel this way, which is really sad actually. But without further ado, I'm going to take you through the 5 plants that I regret selling. The first plant, oh my God. Okay, I didn't even sell this first plant that long ago. I think I sold it maybe a year ago in like March. I think it could have been slightly before that, could have been slightly after that. But I bought a long time ago. I'm pretty sure this was when I was in my first flat that I, you know, when I did videos on my channel, like way back when, in my bedroom, I bought a gorgeous philodendron golden dragon. And I worshipped the ground this thing walked on. I'm pretty sure I got some good compliments on it when I hauled it back then, because I don't think it wasn't a rare plant, kind of. I mean, it kind of was, but it was pretty uncommon. So a lot of people hadn't seen it before. I've always had really good positive feedback about it. And it was always one of my favorites. But the problem is, as with a lot of things, the problem was I had to move house. So I couldn't take every large plant that I'd acquired because this new, I say house, this flat was so much smaller than the one that I was in, right? I used to live in a duplex. It wasn't actually a house or a flat. It was kind of in between. But I had so much room for larger plants. And if you look at my old house plant tools, you'll see this. So I downgraded quite a lot, like significantly on space. And I had so many plants that I wanted to keep, but I had to get rid of some because I had to. I didn't have the space. So some made the cut, some didn't. Okay, so I didn't get rid of it straight away. What actually happened was I took it to my shop and it lived at my shop for months. So I did take it out of the flat and I took it to the shop. But it just sat in a corner and it wasn't being loved and it was taking up a lot of space. And I think I sold it before I knew I was upgrading shops, right? I just didn't have the space for it. And I sold it and I've done nothing but regret it ever since. I do have, can you see it now? Where is it? Is it on this side? It's down there. It's this one here where my finger is. That is a golden dragon narrow form. In fact, I'll get it for you. 2 seconds. I have this plant here, this golden dragon narrow form, kind of similar but different. I guess you could just say it's a little bit more narrow. Hopefully this focuses. It's actually a new lens. So if it doesn't like anything, that's why. So this is essentially a golden dragon. It's just narrow. And I've got this because I really, really, really miss the original that I had. It was big. It was beautiful. And just honestly, it's just one of these things where you really want to turn back the clock and just unsell it. But that's actually why I have this in here, because I'm a little bit obsessed with it. Really quick, unrelated note on these. This is not philodendron longolobatum. These are getting sold as that all the time. Honestly, it's a little bit disturbing. I don't think it's done deliberately. I think a lot of it's just done not knowing. But yeah, be careful with that, by the way, because these are often sold as longolobatum. They're not. I mean, this specimen here doesn't have very big lobes on it, but I have some downstairs that do, and they do look kind of similar. So be careful about that if you're buying a baby longolobatum. So yeah, the golden dragon is, I don't know if it's the most pined after on this list, but it's definitely up there. I really, really miss that plant, honestly. And I don't think you can really buy them right now. I know I'm saying this in the present situation, obviously, but I haven't seen them. And honestly, if I did see a large one, I would probably pick it up because I miss the old one so much. So unfortunately, that's one of my main regrets. Okay, next on this list, I don't think, tell me if I'm wrong, I don't think I hold this plant. I think I got this plant, it was a long time ago, my goodness. I think I picked up maybe about three philodendron red moons. I had three, I think they came from Thailand, they weren't in good condition, I'm pretty sure two of them died, and I had one left, right? And it sat in the shop, it barely grew for like 6 months because there was just no root on it. But it eventually grew a little bit. It wasn't growing well because I don't think I could give it at the time anyway what it really needed in terms of conditions. It grew okay. And I was having a bit of a rearrange in the shop. You know, I was grouping up all my plants into different categories just so I can monitor them better. Not always the case, but sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. It just depends. And I came across this red moon. And I'm pretty sure, I'm sorry, Ben, I'm going to call you out. I think it was Ben that suggested that I sell it on the shop. And that, I mean, I understand why he said that. He basically said, you know, I think you should sell it because there is only one. You can't really propagate off it. It's clearly a very slow grower. It's pretty, but in terms of your business, it's not that useful. I ended up selling it. I think I sold it for around about £250 on the website. I don't think you can buy them now. I don't know. And I regret that because I had one of them and now it's something I'd love to add to a collection. So I wish I hadn't sold it, and that's because I wish I'd kept it for my personal collection. It's kind of a shame that I haven't. Obviously, again, you can't turn back the clock. I could be wrong, but I think the person that bought it might be a subscriber. So if you own that red moon, please let me know how it's doing below. I'd love to know. I do remember it well. It was a tiny little thing. Hopefully it's a lot bigger and a lot better now. Maybe you've sold it on, maybe you've kept it. I don't know, no judgment. But I'm just really curious to see how that is because I really miss it. And I've never seen another red moon since. I've never seen anybody stocking red moon since. I've seen the odd photograph on Facebook, but I don't really see people owning it. And it's such a beautiful, unique plant. The leaves come in kind of yellowy and they've got big red patches on them. I think the yellow fades down to a green and the red fades down to a kind of a weak red color. So it's a really, really interesting plant. But I sold it. So that's a big shame. Ah, the next plant. Okay. So the next plant I have tried to replace about three times and I've failed every time just because the quality and the strength of the specimen just wasn't there. Not only that, but the size, to be honest. And the next plant on my list that I really regret selling is my philodendron bilotai variegata. Now then, I have had variegated bilotai in since. They have not been stable at all. I think a while back, it might have been around about the time I came back from Thailand, I'm not 100% sure, but I hold a really big one. And if I remember correctly, I think I had a half moon leaf and everything, and it was just amazing. I still have that bilotai. Right, I haven't sold it. But it's somewhere in the back of my shop growing pretty much green. It'll either grow an all green leaf or an all yellow leaf. So I've fallen into that trap that I know many of you probably fall into when you buy cuttings like that. So although I have it, it's not stable, it's not viable. You couldn't really look at it and say it was a variegated bilotai, which is a real shame. And I'm just really sad about it because the one I did have, I can't remember how many leaves it had on, but the variegation was just really well distributed on the plant. It was beautiful. I think it had one all yellow leaf. I have one picture on my Instagram of me touching my old variegated bilotai, but I think I sold it. And the reason I sold that one, being totally transparent with you, was for the purposes of drumming up capital for the business. So I didn't really want to sell it at that point, but the amount of money that they were going for, I think back then I sold one of that size for around about, I mean, I could be wrong. I think it was around about 650 Great British Pounds. That was maybe a couple of years ago. And that was really good capital for my business at the time. So I did what I had to do there. But I really regret that. On the basis that I've never found one as good, I haven't found any stable. The quality is just nowhere near what that one was. Just nowhere near. And it had really good roots. It was doing so well. And I hope whoever has it, it's grown beautifully for them. I really do. Because it was a gorgeous, gorgeous plant. I don't regret selling it in terms of, obviously, I needed the capital, but for obviously personal reasons, I really regret that. That is such a shame. It was so pretty. I am gutted. Because now, I don't really have a variegated bilotai to kind of show off anywhere. I don't have one. I mean, I have one, but it's not really much of anything. And that's a real, real shame. And that has happened with every replacement bilotai I've tried to purchase. Every time I bring one in, the leaves might drop off due to shipping because they don't ship amazingly. And they come back either, you know, all green, all yellow leaf, and it will just alternate. And it is just horrendous. Let me know if anybody else has had a similar experience because I'm really curious because that's all that's happened to me. Second to last plant on my list, I have the philodendron Esmeraldensi Large. Now, if you've watched my rare plant wishlist video that was last week, you'll know that I mentioned this plant. And I'm pretty sure on that video, the image I used for the plant is the one that I sold. So that plant there that I, no doubt I'm showing you a picture of now, that was in the shop. It was my first launch and I didn't want to sell it, but I really wanted to provide the range of plants for the launch. I thought that'd be really cool. Let's get a really varied launch because it's my first launch. So I thought, you know what? I'm sure I can get another one. I'm sure there's no problem. I'm sure that's absolutely easy to find. I will have no issues. So I sold it. And I think 2 weeks or less, maybe even a week, I tried to get another one. None. Literally none. I may have had two. Did I have two in stock or one in stock? I can't remember. It was so long ago. This was like, what was this, 2018, I think? Just such a shame. I think I sold it to someone in the UK, maybe. Beautiful, beautiful plant. Now, knowing what I know now, I don't feel the worst about it. And that is because I know that that cutting, when it grew a new leaf, the new leaf wouldn't have been as big. But obviously at the time, I was very new to this and I didn't necessarily have that understanding. So that's probably how I've been able to like process my grief a little bit. But I just really wish I hadn't got rid of that one. And as with any plant I've sold, if you happen to own that exact plant that I've sold, I wish you the best with it. I'm not sat here being salty or anything, but yeah, I just wish I'd kept it for me. Because now, as I said in my last video, you can't get these plants of size. The biggest one I've seen that someone owns in, you know, their house might be maybe that long. And obviously, I think the specimen I had, like on my body now, the leaf was maybe that long, I would say. So I'm really missing out on that, and that's such a shame. But it was a gorgeous plant. If I found one big, I would get it. But it's honestly getting to the point where maybe I should just get a small one and grow it. And just grow it up a pole, grow it on the wall. I don't know. So we'll see how it goes with that one. As I say, it's on my wish list this year. Will I get it? I don't know. I don't know. Because I haven't found any. Real big shame, that one. Real big shame. Okay, the last plant on my list is the philodendron serpens. Now let me explain this. Okay. I have philodendron serpens. Is it in here? Oh no, it is here. It is here. Give me a minute. It's just droopy. It's very droopy. And I believe it is very droopy because it's been sat on the shelf looking for light and it hasn't done very well. Full disclosure, this is philodendron serpens. Yes, it doesn't look very good. This is basically damaged from shipping. This is the original leaf, but I've kept it on because it's firm. It's good. It's firm in the pot as well, to be fair. I was worried about root rot. This is its new leaf here. So this is, I mean, it's a little bit miserable. We can say that, okay? We can say that. It's a bit miserable. Beautiful plant. I'm sure it'll grow big and strong. Probably needs a bit more light, but it's a little bit miserable. So I'll just pop him down. When I originally hauled my philodendron serpens, it came in with a batch of other ones and I kept it because it was so much. I remember why I kept it. I kept it for me. I'd wanted one for a while. I didn't take the first couple that came in, but I wanted one so much. And this serpens came in and I remember it so well. It was shaped like a trident, and I know that sounds really weird, but it was. I should have footage of it here. I think I kind of remember around about the time I got it. And I loved that. It was weird, don't get me wrong, it was very weird, but I loved it. And it was big and it was beautiful and it grew really well. But again, I had so many plants in that new place. I took my plant collection down a bit, I whittled the numbers down, I moved, and then obviously my shop was in full flourish because we remember, if anyone remembers this far back, I launched the shop on the same day I moved house, which, by the way, I don't recommend. That's not something I recommend for anybody. I just got plants in and then I realized, I think I even said at the start of that haul, you know, hey, I've just realized I have unlimited access to plants now. And I went a bit crazy. The serpens was one of the plants I went a little bit crazy with. And again, because it was a larger specimen, I got rid of it. I did bring it back to the shop. I didn't throw it away. I didn't, you know, do anything like that. I think it would have been sold at some point to somebody. Probably sold as a large, I think, because it was huge. Certainly nothing like this here. This is tiny compared to the one I had. That was the main reason why I did sell it, to be honest. It was a space thing. I'm finding now, moving to this unit and having this nice big studio, now I have the space and I'm like, oh man, why did I get rid of all these big plants? And I'm really feeling it with the serpens as well. I'm kind of okay with this though, because this is a plant that probably wouldn't have made it on this list, but it has done because I need five. I probably wouldn't have put this on. I do regret it. But now that I know I have a couple in the unit and I can grow them, I'm not so sad about it. There is one on the wall, but it's looking a bit unhappy. There's one down here. There might be two downstairs. So I don't have many. Don't get me wrong. I have four, I think. But I have some. So I don't feel as bad about it as what I do the rest of them. So there you go. They are the five plants that I regret selling. If you're interested in me doing a five plants I regret buying, I would love to do that. Let me know in the comments below. Or if there's any other videos from you would like to see, let me know below. I do have a video coming for you on my second channel if anybody's interested, and that should be at some point next week. If you hear my speech is different, there is a reason. I will get into that video on my second channel. I won't bore you with it here, but if you've noticed something different throughout this video, there is something different. If you can't see it, that is. I will explain that on my second channel because I have quite a bit to say about that, actually. But yeah, if you like this video, please leave a like down below. Thank you for spending your time with me today. If you're not already part of the family, I would love to have you here, so please consider subscribing. One last question before we go. Are there any plants that you personally regret selling or giving away or anything like that? Maybe not ones that died, because I might like to do a video on like top plants I've killed. I think that could be really cool. But any plants that you've sold, given away, anything like that, and you just think, oh my God, even if I found another plant in a nursery or online, it's still not going to replace it. And that's honestly the painful part. So basically what I'm saying is I want to hear your pain. Give me your pain in the comment section. I want to read it. That's it for this week, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye.